In this video, we're going to cover the traditional preparation technique versus the biomimetic technique, which conserves a lot of tooth structure and takes away less of your tooth. So let me get my loops on and let's go for it. Okay. So here we have a very typical scenario, which is a silver filling. And the silver filling has cracks, which are these red dots over here. Because a silver filling is a metal filling, but it doesn't adhesively bond or join the tooth together. So every time you chew on this, like every time you're eating, grinding, clenching, any of that, little by little, stresses build up and create cracks in the tooth, okay? The traditional way to address that now is to say, okay, this tooth is structurally compromised, it's not strong, so I need to shave away the whole enamel outer layer and cover it with a crown. So I'm going to show you what that means. It's a lot of shaving, it's a lot of reduction. On average, we're talking about 70 or 75% of the tooth being shaved away. So let's go ahead and do that so you can see what we're talking about for a crown. So first step in a crown, there's different techniques, but most of the time you start with either reducing the outside or the top. Let's do the top first. When you're doing a crown, first you know you need to reduce a large amount of tooth, and you know exactly how much you need to reduce. Different materials have different reductions, but what you do is you make these grooves that are about a millimeter and a half or 2 millimeters deep, so that you know that you have enough space for your crown to be thick enough. So I'm going around making several sets of these grooves. And I'm checking, because I know how big this, see this burr? I know how big it is, okay? So it's about 1.6. And when I do this, I can just check that I'm deep enough everywhere. Okay, now I can go and join these areas together. As you can imagine, we have a lot of tooth reduction here that could have been avoided, and we're not even done yet. So this is called the occlusal reduction. I'm almost done here. That's how much we need to take off the top so that there's room for the crown. Okay, and we see from the side here how much reduction we have. I still need to finesse some things, but this is just the reduction portion. So before I do the finessing, now I'm gonna reduce the sides because a crown covers the top and all around, okay? So just to take care and strengthen this tooth, we have to take away not only a lot of the top, but also the side. So I'm gonna turn this sideways here, and now you can see what we call the axial reduction, which is the reduction on the sides of the teeth. Same idea, I go ahead and place my grooves. Again, depending on the material, we have different reductions, but a rather common reduction amount is 1-1.5 millimeters, depending. So once I have a few of these grooves, I can start joining them again. Okay, so we have some of the side completed here, and this is still pretty conservative for a crown, okay? We've taken away a lot of the side. This is just shy of 1 millimeter on the margins, but we've taken away this whole side of the tooth, and we're right near the gum. And we really want to avoid taking margins near the gum because it's always best to have your own tooth structure up against the gum, but with a crown procedure, you have to go there in order to just have the space for the crown. If you don't go near the gum, you won't have enough retention, which is what holds the crown in place, and then you have problems. So the traditional technique requires a lot of tooth reduction just so that the crown will stay on. But if we were to use adhesion, we wouldn't need to take away the area near the gum because our retention comes from our glue. We don't have to take away more tooth just so the crown can stay on. We can actually use adhesion to make sure that the restoration stays on. Now I'm gonna come right here through the middle. I'm using a smaller burr so I don't get the neighboring tooth. Now we have the side and the top, but not the inside near the tongue. So I'm gonna come back there and we'll work on that again. Let's get this view right over here. So now we have to do the same thing we did on the outside over here. So I'm gonna make a few grooves here. Now I can start connecting again. Okay, so now we have what's called the gross reduction of the crown done, which means we've reduced a majority of what we need to, but now we need to finesse and make sure that we create a shape so that something can come over this. And what does that mean? If I want to put a crown on top of this tooth right here, I need to be able to get the crown to come straight from the top, come all the way over. So it's important that the crown tapers or kind of leans a little bit on each side. Like this side needs to lean inwards. This side also needs to lean inwards. So we're gonna now spend a little bit of time to create that shape that will allow something to sit over the top without getting stuck. So I kind of give it a little bit of shape up here. Okay, now we'll go to the other side. Do the same thing. So I'm gonna take away this sharp edge and make sure there's a little bit of lean. Okay. And lastly, smoothing the top surface, which we worked on originally. So now I'm gonna take a look everywhere, make sure I have what's called convergence, which means I have the ability for a crown to seat over without having any area that would hold it up, okay? So I look on all the sides here, make sure I have the basically an angle that kind of approaches the middle of the tooth. So you see here, if I were to continue, I'm kind of tapering towards the center. Same thing on this side. Then we look from the sides over here and confirm, same thing. And we're essentially done. There's still a little bit of refining that I would normally do here for a crown, but very important is that I would never normally prep this tooth for a crown, okay? You can see how much tooth we took away. Let me clean this up a little bit. So we took away this much tooth in order to supposedly strengthen a tooth that had problems from the previous silver filling and cracks, okay? Now in the next prep, I want to show you what I would do for the same situation with the biomimetic approach, which saves at least 30 to 40% of what we just removed. Because when we look here, we removed about 70% of the volume of the tooth that's above the gum. So this is about a 70% reduction from here to there. And that is also associated with higher chance of root canals, higher chance of sensitivity, and other problems such as irritation around the gum lines and inflammation, harder to keep clean and so on. Okay guys, so I cleaned up this so you can see it better. So here's our completed crown preparation. And really important to notice or to note is that this is still considered a conservative crown preparation. The margin I have right over here where the crown will end is not that big of a margin compared to what we typically see in the traditional approach. So even more would be taken away. But when you look at this, this is still about a 70% reduction in the tooth structure that is above the gums, and all so that the crown could be fitted on there. Because our goal was to strengthen this tooth, but in the traditional approach, we have to take away more of the tooth in order to strengthen it. And that's counterintuitive. And with adhesion and biomimetic dentistry, we're able to strengthen that tooth while keeping more of the parts that are not damaged.